Hey, can I help?
Can you get out of my face?
Hey, can I help? Hey, can I help?
Well, you're the French called Laissez Copidon.
Look what you did, idiot!
This whole class hates me. I wish everyone would disappear.
Riley, you don't mean that. If you woke up tomorrow and we were gone, you'd be really sad.
Yes, I do. You guys are all jerks. I just want you all to disappear. They're all jerks. It'd be so much better if I woke up and they weren't here.
Where are we?
Duh, Giovanna, we're in the North Pole.
But how did we get here?
The reindeer.
What reindeer?
Open your eyes and look. There's Rudolph and the rest of his gang.
Oh, can we please go?
Yeah.
Parker, we found the reindeer, but where's Santa?
We should probably go look for him while we run through recaps.
Maddie Shelfo and Gracie Mattson were definitely blooming during this year's Daffodil Princess selection. We'd like to give a big thanks to last year's Daffodil Princess Brianna Olson for making an appearance. A big shout out to both of these outstanding girls and congratulations to Gracie Mattson for being this year's Daffodil Princess.
Thanks to Five High School's 2018 food drive, there will be no empty stomachs this holiday. Five High School raised $3,128 and over 2,800 food items together. Trojans are all about serving the community. The bells were ringing and the elves were singing as they granted winter wishes to five high school students. Thank you, students and staff, for donating and making the holidays brighter for so many five students.
It's because your grades improved by 0.5 from our last grading period to this quarter grading period. So we wanted to congratulate you as well for working on getting your grades up and doing the right thing.
In addition to the tasty breakfast, prizes were raffled off. Everything from Sour Patch Kids to the crowd favorite, a Bob Ross game. The Renaissance breakfast was Five High School's version of the Happy Meal.
After some convincing, I decided to go ahead with it. And so we established Fife's first ever toy drive. Our original goal was 700. Within the first 4 days, we'd accomplished the 700 toys. We just continued to blow that number out of the water. You'd see tables filled with stuffed animals, filled with new toys, filled with gently used toys. Tomorrow is our toy giveaway. And so we've invited needy families and children and people from all over the community to come to Fife between 12 and 4 tomorrow and pick up a toy for the holiday season. I can't tell you enough, Fife High School, all the great things you did. I can't say thank you enough. Nice job, Fife High School.
A lot of little kids will be warm and cozy this winter because of FCCLA's pajama drive. Close to 150 pajamas were collected and will be given to Seattle Children's Hospital. Thanks to FCCLA, lots of kids will be warm and cozy this holiday season. Thank you, FCCLA.
Fife Got Talent, from singing to comedy, five students really put on a show at Cafe Night. Thank you to National Honor Society for putting together this wonderful night of entertainment.
The drops could be better. Oh.
Hi, Santa.
Holy cow, are we ready for Christmas?
Yes, we are.
Me too. Are you going to leave me cookies and milk?
Of course.
And carrots for the reindeer?
Yes.
Oh, awesome. How cool. So, what do we want for Christmas? She has to do like... Really?
Yes.
Okay, and I want, like, I've been wanting this my whole life. I really, really, really want a Lego Death Star.
No way.
Yeah.
Merry Christmas, Fife High School. Get them, Trojans.
Shula? 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 I made my classmates disappear. I made my classmates disappear.
Hey, Harry. Yeah, Marv. You know what really bugs me?
What's that?
I never get on Trojan TV. They always edit me out.
Yeah, I've noticed that.
I was thinking, why don't we break into Trojan TV and make our own episode? Wet Bandit style.
Sticky Bandit style.
Merry Christmas.
Very Merry Christmas.
The fourth annual John McCrossin Classic has been, it's been a great day. We've got four games in. I got a game starting behind us here in a few minutes, and it's been a great way to get basketball people together, and John has always been about people and basketball.
Great way to honor John McCrossin, who was Mr. Basketball here in Fife for so many years and around the Puget Sound. We've got the referees there donating their time today on the floor. The money that they would have made, we're gonna donate to cancer research. And we've got all the proceeds will either go to cancer research or to the John McCrossin Memorial Scholarship. It's been some high-flying games. It's been a great day, and if you weren't here, you should have been.
Hi, I'm Connie McCrossin, and I'm John McCrossin's widow. And I'm down here at the John McCrossin Memorial Basketball Classic. John was a true supporter of Fife. First of all, he had a real passion for basketball. He just loved the game.
We love coming to Tacoma. It's where I grew up. It's where I know the best basketball is. And also specifically Fife High School, because this is where we got knocked out last year. Coach Shelvert coaches a really tough squad, and we wanted to prove to our guys that we could win on this floor. Someday we're gonna come back here and get them.
Hey, we just finished up the John McCrossin Classic. What an amazing event. I don't know if people really realize how special John McCrossin is. I think we know, we have our individual stories of how he impacted us, and he certainly, even though I just got to Fife High School, he even had an impact on me, and he actually had a role in me wanting to be a Fife Trojan. But just being able to see his lasting legacy and what it does, and bringing all these people here together this weekend for cancer and for community, just to do something good for those that are in need, truly amazing. And I'm just so thankful that Fife High School still is connected to John McCrossin.
Fife's wrestling team hosted the annual Larry Brown Wrestling Tournament this past weekend. The tournament celebrates Fife's legendary coach, Larry Brown. Schools all around the Puget Sound area came to compete in the largest wrestling event that is held at Fife High School.
Things that are like really rewarding, like for example when we do like a dance that like we all are kind of struggling with, and then going out and performing it and then coming back and just feeling so proud that we went from like not knowing anything really to coming and performing in front of everyone. And it just feels like, I don't know, it just feels nice to know that we like finally reached that goal.
Okay, so I'm pretty sure that all of you guys know this, but instead of having only girls on this cheer team, we also have boys. And this is different at Fife because we are the first ever in Fife history boys on the cheer team. And I feel like we're just beginning a new era, a new wave of cheering at Fife because we're starting something different.
Okay, we just wanted to thank you as a Fife High cheer team, to thank the crowd members that always cheer us up even when sometimes we may feel like we're not doing as good a job as we could be. They cheer us up, and it helps us to cheer everyone else up as well. And they always cheer us on. And we also we're very privileged to be able to support all the sports teams and be able to support the school as a whole.
Yell blue, white, Trojans, let's fight. Yell blue, white, Trojans, let's fight.
I'm playing Scrooge. It's a pretty fun role. It's challenging because there's so much that I had to do, because I have to go from being an extremely angry, grouchy person to someone who's full of joy and giddy as can be. And I have to be able to connect those two things throughout the story.
Rest in peace, Ebenezer Scrooge.
My name is Jenna, and I've been doing plays since eighth grade. And I play Belinda in this play, and she's one of the Cratchit kids. And one of the best parts is just having a family, and I just love the whole vibe of this play.
Do you really think so?
Of course you will, Jen. You'll be ever so much better before you know it.
I'm playing Mr. Hempstead, who is a charity worker. And probably the most fun thing about that is I get to interact with Thomas Lewis, who I've had in class for the last couple years, and he gets to yell at me and point in my face and stuff, and it's just kind of fun to see him in a different environment.
It's a quality of life for these people and their poor families. It's
It's hardly a decent existence.
I'm the pawnbroker, and what the pawnbroker is, he's when Christmas Future is showing Scrooge how his life turns out. People are selling Scrooge's stuff to me. I buy and sell dead people's things. What's really fun about the part is that I have a solo. This is my first time having a solo, and it's character singing, which I really love. I get to do a British accent, which I've worked on for I don't know how long. Overall, it's a really fun part.
If you were in our position, you'd likely do it too.
That's right.
After all, you can't take it with you.
Alright, I'm ready.
I am Leah, and I am playing Tiny Tim. And my favorite part about being in this play is because it is really fun.
God bless us, everyone.
A Christmas Carol has been just so much fun because I wrote the script and Dave wrote fabulous music, and we have got the perfect group of kids to put it on. Thomas Lewis is just amazing. He's incredible with his transformation to Scrooge. And he is funny, he's bold, and all the actors have been so fun to work with, and it's just the whole ensemble is so terrific, and they're like a family, and they bonded, and they get along, and the things they write about how this feels like a family in the program when they write their bio, the biggest thing is the family feel, and that means a lot to Dave and I that we provide that family feel for them. So that's why this is so much fun and we love doing it, because they're our family too.
Yo, what's going on, Trojans? It's Parker and Derek back with another episode of Parker's Place. We all know it's the holiday season. Well, what's up, Derek? What's going on?
Winter wishes.
What did you wish for?
A big present, I guess.
A big present. I know the limit's $20, but anyone out there that wants to buy me a Lego Death Star, please buy me a Lego Death Star. Thanks.
That's pretty reasonable.
So, Derek, what do you do around the holidays?
Personally, you know, I'm Canadian, dual citizen, so I usually go up to Canada with my family relatives and stuff, yeah.
Oh, really? Yeah, he goes to Canada.
What was the air quotes for?
I saw you.
In Canada?
No. I would never go to Canada.
Where'd you see me then?
Saw you in Clark's room.
Oh, Clark's
room. What were you guys doing? Once I came in, she instantly kicked me out.
I mean, okay, if you really want to know, I was just like, Clark talks a lot of crap to me, all right? Like, constantly. She doesn't think that I'm the better individual. So I was like, you gotta settle it once and for all. Gingerbread competition.
A gingerbread competition?
Like, you know, like, designing and making it.
Like the house? Or,
yeah.
Like, making gingerbread?
No.
And then seeing whose gingerbread tastes better?
No, the house. The design.
The house?
Yeah. Like the, we got custom, or we got, like, store-bought gingerbread houses, so everything's the same.
Like the ones from Costco?
Exactly. The same, yeah, exactly Costco. And then, we got, like, 20 minutes to see who could make the best.
Well, house. Who won?
Well, I think I won by a long shot. First, her icing broke. Her house broke down. She can't design worth anything, so I think I won, honestly.
Yeah, okay. Do you have proof?
My memory.
Clark, you mean 101 right now.
One-on-one what?
Bam! Gingerbread.
Ready to lose?
Talking about yourself, fool.
Ready, set, go.
Hey guys, what's up?
Whose class are you supposed to be in?
Oh. Okay, bye.
Bye, Parker.
Bye, Derek.
Told you.
Wow, Derek.
That was a really good gingerbread house.
What did I tell you? Hers was terrible compared to mine.
I know. And now I need to tell the people who won.
Thank you. Thank you. Just let them know.
Listen up, Fife High School. The winner of the 2018 gingerbread house competition is Derek Sagan.
Let's go. I'm told, Ms. Clark.
Hey, that was a great episode of Parker's Place. Really fun to film. Shout out to Derek. Always fun doing this with you. Shout out to my crew. Shout out, Ms. Clark. You did a great job with the gingerbread house. Derek did way better, though. So, you know, Trojans, check this out.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock.
Snowing and blowing and bushels of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bell chime in jingle bell time.
Dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square. In the frosty air.
Jingle bells time, it's a swell time to jingle go gliding in a one-horse sleigh.
Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet. Jingle around the clock. Mix and a mingling, jingling feet.
Cause that's the jingle bell rock.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bell chime and jingle bell time.
Dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square in the frosty air.
What a bright time, it's the right time to rock the night away.
Jingle Bell time, it's a swell time to go riding in a one-horse sleigh.
Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet. Jingle around. Mix and a mingle and jingle and feet.
That's the jingle bell. That's the jingle bell. That's the jingle bell rock.
Riley, there you
Dad.
Are. Man, I was so worried about you.
I love you.
Love you too, Riley. I didn't know what was going on. It is so good to have the TDM crew back.
Cool, you're hot.
Oh, wow.
And you don't have a question?
No.
Alright. And go.
My name is Gabriel. This is Dude Perfect. And this is the pretzel shot at Clayton. Oh, hey. We were making a video. Oh, hey. I didn't see you there. My name is Gabriel, and,
Yo, 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 what's crack-a-lackin', Trojans? That was so dumb. Oh my god.
Melanie, how do you feel working with these boys?
Can you just keep it zoomed in? Ready to lose?
No, I'm not ready to lose.
Thank you.
you got. Make them wish that they were none. On the outside looking, boy.